Good evening, viewers. You are watching the news in focus with me, Cindy. Today, every day, October 9, 2020, I'll present to you about the hot news for today. And the news is about the poverty cases in Indonesia. The poverty case in Indonesia has been becoming a common problem for developing countries. Around 64.67 million people in Indonesia, there are still 25.91 million people living in the poverty line. The problem of poverty in Indonesia has become apprehensive because the COVID-19 that attacked Indonesia. Since COVID-19 has entered Indonesia, the economic condition has been increasing the worst condition. The impact of COVID-19 is increasingly visible. The addition of the number of new cases caused the large-scale limitation barrier, or PSBB, in several regions to be further extended. This condition has resulted in the economic sector in Indonesia becoming increasingly unstable. Many people are harmed by this pandemic. Some workers are required to implement work from home. Moreover, there's not a few of them had to be laid off because their workplace had to be closed indefinitely. This will constantly increase the number of poverty cases in Indonesia. The head of BPS Suharyanto said, that the number of poor has increased, the percentage of poor has increased. The Central Statistic Agency or DPS noted that the poverty rate as of March 2020 had increased to 26.42 million people, with this position, the percentage of poor people as of March 2020 also increased to 9.78%. In responding to the social problems, the government has prepared hundreds of trillions of funds to help people that affected by COVID-19. The donation can be in the form of basic necessities, direct cash donation, waivers for electricity costs, and pre-employment cuts, as well as other social donation. This donation list reached the hands of the people starting last April. Reportedly, this donation will last for 2 months. However, due to the addition of positive cases of COVID-19 that continue to increase, it also has an impact on the trend for PSBB, which is also extended. Following that condition, the donation from government will be extended till the end of this year. In East Java, the percentage of poverty has also increased from 10.20% in September 2019 to 11.9% in March 2020. This condition is almost the same throughout Indonesia. Indeed, there is an issue about the job write-off of poor countries by the World Bank. On March 25th, the World Bank is led by David Malpass, and the IMF has said that the job of poor countries should be wiped out. This plan will be discussed jointly with the G7 and G20 countries. Reportedly, the G20 official countries supported the proposal submitted by the World Bank. The proposal contains a request to China and other major creditors to postpone the payment of developing countries. This is so that developing countries can use the funds to deal with the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. David Malpass, the president of the World Bank, hopes that the proposal on debt suspension for developing countries can be approached, especially by China, where China has been giving the largest lender for developing countries for 2 decades. Malpass also said that the World Bank will cooperate with the IMF and member countries of the IDA of International Development Association. Okay, viewers, that's all of the news for today. We meet again in the same time and same channel. Thank you for your attention and goodbye.